We wanted to test the hypothesis that if you're trained to work in a particular spatial profession, it might change the way you think about space.
There's the picture of nature, which is round, fat, you can grab it, you can pick it up, and you can walk around inside of it. And then there's the nature of the picture, and the nature of the picture is flat. And so that you're changing something which is round into something which is flat. I'm always looking for shapes, because that's what you can do when you're painting. You can, really, all you can do is make a shape.
What we found was that the architects generally talked about the path through the space in these images, where they would go in the space, even when they're describing it. Whereas the painters would think about the 2D and the 3D space presented in the image. So how the different planes are working, and they would flip between these different perspectives. And the sculptors were somewhere between the two, sometimes like a painter, sometimes more like an architect. The other thing we found was that if you look at just two words, back and end, so if somebody describes the image by describing the back of the image, they're much more likely to be a painter than the other professions. Whereas if they use the word end of the image, they're much more likely to be an architect. And that fit with other measures we took from the way they describe the space. The architects are more interested in the paths. So where's the end of the path in the image? And the painters are more obsessed with the foreground, background of the image, so the back of the image. So even just honing down into just two words, we can sort of get a sense of how the profession these people undertake changes how the way they conceive the space.
You know, you're stuck with the flatness of the canvas. I've made it slightly surreal. I've pulled lots of different levels into it. There's a kind of very flat, there's the idea of the flat painting.
It's a long-standing theory that how you learn about the world, the training you receive, your profession, actually influences your thought. And this is evidence that we've got here that is the case.